Okay, are you ready for this? Because this is going to be pretty huge. In about less than 12 hours, we are going to be having the preview for the Bleach anime, the Thousand Year Blood War arc, which has been confirmed because I do have it with me right now. I'm not going to be showing you the PV. However, I am going to be showing you some really cool images. And I'm pretty shaken right now because these are amazing, and we're gonna show them and talk to you right now. I do want to give a massive shout out to OECUF for providing me with these images, because these guys are goats, and I do recommend you go follow them in the link in the description down below. But man, let's talk about these images because this is insane. It looks amazing. So first and foremost, we are going to be showing, boom, right off the bat, Rukia, one of the best girls, and this is probably one of the shots of just before she's about to get attacked, and by God, look how clean that is. It looks very close to the manga, yet its own anime style with it as well. The lighting, the dark theme that is the invasion, the first invasion arc, and the shock that you can see from the face looks amazing. This key visual looks beautiful, and having also the foreshadow effect with that as well. So again, if you're a Rukia fan, you are going to love how this is going to look. I'm so excited to see, again, in a few hours, to see the actual full PV to you guys and react to it. So yeah, even though it's a bit of a low quality image, you can see the little details such as the sweat on the top of the forehead and some really good glare in the eyes and little details in the eyes as well, which you probably won't get from this image, but it looks amazing. It looks beautiful, but it doesn't end there. We've got quite a few images to talk about today. Next up, we have the Renji scene, a bit of a different bit of lighting here. This is exactly where he's about to attack Masty Masculine after Byakuya has a little bit of a battle with Asuna. And as you can tell, sorry if nothing is fluent in my voice right now. I'm excited. I'm unprepared for this. But again, on model, lovely shadowing, lovely lighting, love the grey, even though it was in the Rukia one too, you can see it more prominent, the grey background as well, where it's a bit shadowy, and you can tell it really fits the theme of the dark tone of the first invasion, and I'm really surprised that we're going to get this in the PV. These are probably the first 1 to 2, maybe even 3 episodes going straight into this. So again, beautiful shot of Renji here. You can see the desperation, the anger of Renji in this fight, especially when it comes to the manga counterpart. I'm really interested to see how his facial features are going to be moving into this, especially with him trying to protect Byakuya of all people. So again, looks beautiful. Right, on to the next one. We have not only one, but two panels of this one. We have the first set of captains here being Kensei, Shinji, Komamura, Kensei, Kenpachi, and Uketake. Look at the layout of this. Look at the colouring and the shadows of this. It really sets, like, from what we are used to seeing of the Bleach captain meetings, you can really tell that there's a really serious undertone in this, because usually we see it all colourful, vibrant, very old-fashioned, like Japanese Kyoto-style layout, and now we have a very dark setting at the very bottom with a very dim light at the top, showing a very menacing, yet at the same time a very surreal feeling within this room, and seeing the seriousness of all the captains. Like, yeah, there's always seriousness within these captain meetings, but it really just fleshes out the concern. You can see, such for Shinji, how, like, he's kind of questioning what's going on. Kensei is very, like, serious about this as well. Kenpachi is like, huh, like, are these guys really that big of a threat? Now again, like, Kenpachi usually in these meetings doesn't really seem that bothered, but it seems to have caught his attention, and Uketake really taking on board what's going on here. So again, look at the lighting. I'm really impressed. The glistening of Kensei's hair at the back, but like the more dimmer shadows at the front, really gives you a perspective on just Akudama Drive's really light in here, and Taguchi's real expertise at work here. Next one, again, following the same suit on the other side of the captain's meeting. Can I just take a moment to appreciate Shunsui's kimono type garb? Like, it's so detailed. I mean, I saw the character sheets of the old anime of Shunsui, how they only did half of the robe, because obviously there's a lot of detail, right? But look at the detail on Shunsui right now. That is really, like, lots of different fading, lots of little bits of things that you probably would find annoying to animate. So I'm really interested to see what kind of process they did in making sure that this is consistent throughout, because obviously Shunsui has a lot of fights throughout. But again, keeping that same lighting, really putting a lot of emphasis and a lot of attention, not only on the pins on the back of his hair, but also the robe as well. But also as well, really kind of encapsulating the height differences and when I was looking through the character sheets of the Bleach characters, they do put a lot of emphasis on the size of the characters. So you can tell there's a big difference there and the use of camera angles here. Seeing as Soifan's at the very back and Tashira at the very front, you can see the distance as well. And again, the flare of the light at the back on the wall, again, very beautiful, very vibrant. And it gives you, even though it's really dark and there's a big contrast, you can see the seriousness on each of their faces. Like, these shots look amazing. I mean, I can't praise them enough. I didn't expect Bleach to have this amount of work put into it. I don't know. I haven't even shown you guys the PV, so it's difficult to show you what my expectations were, but holy shit. Coming up with the next image is one of the best girlfriend Quincy waifus, Bambietta, motherfucking Bastabine. Look at her. She looks great. I mean, look, I love the glistening of the sword. There's a lot of details in the swords, which I really appreciate. Back in the Fullbring arc, it seems that they've carried that on. Some good movement speed going on here as well. And you can also see the sadistic, crazy side of Bambietta Bastabine as well. So, like, again, nothing that I dislike about this panel as a whole. And it looks just crisp and clear. So, again, great. Next up, we have a shot of Baz B. Again, honestly, I thought his hair would have looked a little bit more thicker, if that makes sense. But again, incorporating a great panel shot here. Maybe this is how they made their entrance. I guess a lot of you manga readers will probably pull this scan up. But again, loving the blue and dark shadowy effects here. And it just really glistens. You can see the white, the grey, the dark grey. And then also the flaring of like a tinted blue on his neck. And all these different shadows are just screams to Gucci. And I love it. Next one, Hushvolt. Well, however you want to pronounce it. Hush Browns, as what the meme used to be. Again, beautiful camera shot here. Forward-facing shot. Lovely glares in the lighting. And it just looks perfect. I mean, the detail in the hair alone. Like, one thing I really didn't like about Burn the Witch was how flat it looked. Like, it was fluid as hell. But of how flat it looked. And I'm glad it's not the same with this anime. And there is a lot of details. Especially within the close-up shots where there is a lot of details in the hair. Because, again, the less lines, the better, right? But there's a lot of line art going on here. So I can imagine production was insane and annoying. But it looks exactly how it is, and that's gorgeous. Following up with the man himself, our antagonist, Yuha Bok. Yes, I said it right. I didn't say you watched this time. Again, with a nice white to black background. I'm guessing this is in the Shadow Palace of the Waterworld, or the Shadow Dimension, if you want to call it that. And again, seeing the lighting off his face and just the blackness behind him is a great contrast to show himself as a villain. And I would imagine that this is one of his first appearances as well. So again, on model, looks great. Give him that Chad jawline. And you can tell already, even though he's smiling and he's looking down on someone, you can tell how menacing this shot is. And again, you just can't scream. Just quality. Before I show you the last image, if you haven't liked, hit that like button right now. If you haven't clicked the subscribe, click the subscribe, because we will be keeping up to date with all the Bleach news, because I have saved one of the best images for last. And that is one of the most iconic scenes in Bleach, and that is the "Please Save the Soul Society, Ichigo Kurosaki." It is arguably one of the most detailed shots in the Bleach manga, and when it comes to the anime, holy, it doesn't miss. Like, you can see the rain, you can see the droplets at the back, you can see even behind the shadows, you can see the line art of definition within his skin, the glare on his eyes, the absolute emotion, and those thick lines where it's needed on the nose, on the mouth. And again, the different three different shadow effects on his hair even looks like blue, because there's a bit of blue colouring fading into the hair as well. So there's a lot going on here. And I'm beyond, and I mean beyond, impressed, because again, the hair looks like it has life into it. It's not just straight cut hair pieces. It looks like it has volume to it, like the rain's hitting on the hair and like it's weighing it down. The definition, especially within Yakubo's art style, the definition of wrinkles when a character like squints its eyes and it has those like skin folds within the eye to the nose, those are there. That looks great too. And just, it just looks amazing. And you can see almost like a bit of sun glare on the back of his head coming down to the front. So again, I'm really interested to see just everything in motion, react with it with you guys. And just, wow, my expectations were so low I didn't really quite know what to expect. Anything that was Fullbring was acceptable to me, but this is beyond any expectation that I had, and it's blown so much like confidence in how I'm seeing this right now. And again, I hope the PV really solidifies that for us, because the expectations right now, as I'm recording this, are insanely high. With that being said, I am going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day in hand. And tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below. And with that being said, you guys, of course, have this fine day in hand. Peace out.